que ces grands jours marquent les débuts d'une grande histoire entre eux deux. Shall this day be the beginning of a great story between you two? Et que cette histoire soit longue, pleine d'amour, de bonne santé et la joie de vivre. And may that story be a long one, full of love, good health, and the joy of living.
Thank you.
my great pleasure to welcome you all here this afternoon to celebrate this wonderful occasion and witness the beginning of the next phase in Amelie and Will's commitment and love to each other. They have asked me to tell you how humbled they are that you have all, their very loved friends and family, have travelled so far from all over France, from the UK, from the United States, from Singapore, and of course, Australia. And it was now some 5 years ago when I first met Amelie, and she came over to me and she said, "Dave, I am so sorry I am not going to get to meet Will's father and your great friend. But Will has told me that I need to get to know you because a little bit of John is in you." I was astounded. She was either too divine to be true or so clever. And I have come to love her as the person she is and as a wonderful friend to myself and to all of us ever since I first met her. She is simply divine.
Oui, Amélie. Je suis Richard, le frère d'Amélie, et en son nom et celui de notre famille, j'aimerais vous remercier pour votre présence en ce jour si heureux. Laissez-moi maintenant vous présenter Dave Dalton, qui a été choisi par Amélie et Will pour célébrer leur mariage. Dave connaît Will depuis sa naissance et il a eu le plaisir de le voir grandir. Assister à l'épanouissement également de sa relation avec Amélie au cours des 5 dernières années. Dave était le meilleur ami du père de Will, John, qui nous a quittés il y a maintenant 7 ans.
L'amour est patient, rempli de bonté et désintéressé. Il n'est jamais jaloux. L'amour n'est ni prétentieux ni orgueilleux. Love is passion, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast, it's not proud.
Amelie, do you take Will to be your lawful wedded husband? Do you promise to love and cherish him in sickness and in health, for richer or for poorer, for better or for worse, and be loyal to him so long as you both shall live?
Yes, I do.
Will, do you take Amelie to be your lawful wedded wife? Do you promise to love and cherish her in sickness and in health, for richer or for poorer, for better or for worse, and to be loyal to her, for so long as you both shall live?
Yes, I do. Amelie, you are my love, my passion, and my best friend. You fill my life with overwhelming happiness, the kind that I thought couldn't be any greater, and yet every day I know that somehow it will be tomorrow. You're the reason I start the day smiling and end the day laughing. You're the most wonderful, kind, precious gift, one that I promise to spend the rest of my life carefully unwrapping, appreciating, cherishing, and discovering over and over again. I promise to love you in a way that makes you feel adored, to support you faithfully through challenging times, to hold you in a way that makes you feel safe, and to look to you when I need protection. I promise to give you honesty, respect, trust, and passion, to listen to you and to always try my best to hear you, even when we disagree. I will try to always appreciate the joy in the little moments we have together, eating, drinking, lying on the beach, dancing, chatting, and the big ones, traveling, moving house and starting a family. I promise to hug you when we wake up, when we get home, when we go out, when we stay in, to kiss you when we're cooking, when you're riding, before we sleep, to hold your hand when we're walking together, when we're having dinner, when we're with our friends. I'll build with you, explore with you, and try to always be present with you. You have me and I have you, and I promise to make my love and my life forever yours.
Will, you are my life and the pillar of the only future I could ever imagine building. As I fell in love with you, my vision of life and of what matters slowly changed. Through you, I found the most simple and beautiful sense of peace and happiness. I promise to stay close to you. Hold your hand when you sleep. Like I always have. Hold your face in my hand and comfort you when you doubt and when you're tired of being the strong one. I hope my silly jokes and my often really strange behavior also distract you from the little stories of life in the years to come. I promise to love you always. How could I not? How would I ever get enough of your wit, your smarts, your generosity, and get enough of the way you love me? And if we start taking our love for granted, I promise I will try to bring back all the butterflies, all the ones I feel when I see you in the distance, the one I feel when I see you when I get you to stare at me, and the massive ones that I feel in my chest today as I'm marrying you. I will always put you before all else, and I promise to care for our families and our children's love for as long as I live. I'll give you my hand today, and it is forever yours.
Therefore, by the power invested in me by Amelie and Will, I have the great honour and delight to declare you husband and wife.
Welcome everyone. My name is Mathieu and I am one of the brothers of Amélie. Kaz, Will's mom, is going to start by saying a few words. In French now.
Chère famille, chers amis. Je suis très heureuse de pouvoir vous dire bienvenue au mariage d'Amélie et Will. I'm speaking today as Will's mother and on behalf of his father, John. Our beautiful son, Will, was a truly wonderful child growing up and never gave us any trouble. In fact, he always made us very, very proud. It's so sad that John is not here to celebrate with us here, Will, on your wedding day. What we planted and nurtured in you along the way has now matured. John would be bursting with pride today. Everything Will put his mind to, he excelled at. School, university, and his strong work ethic laid the path for a wonderful career. This part of Will's character makes me feel so confident that he will make a truly wonderful husband. Yes. If somebody asked me to describe the ideal woman to marry my son, I would say that's a pretty tall order. Then along came Amélie. When Amélie walked into my house 5 years ago, I could not believe how much I liked her immediately. She was like a little ray of sunshine that burst into our lives. Her hilarious and cheeky sense of humour, tick, was so refreshing, yet she also has such an intelligent, inquiring mind. Tick, tick. And let's face it, she's goddamn gorgeous. These two are going to be so very happy together. I'm so also lucky to have got to know Claude and Sylvie. We've had a couple of magnificent Christmases together in Australia, and instantly both them and myself knew we were like-minded people. Together now, we are the very proud parents of Will and Amélie Giardini. And hopefully, in the not-too-distant future, we will be the very, very proud grandparents of many little Giardinis. Love you, Ritz.
Thank you, guys. Now, please welcome Claude, father of the bride, to say a few words too. Maintenant, Claude, je ne sais pas si j'ai à vous le présenter, qui va venir nous dire quelques mots aussi.
Mesdames, messieurs, chers amis français et australiens, nous sommes très heureux d'être là ensemble pour le mariage de Will et Amélie. Donc, moi, je ne vais pas parler de Will parce que je ne le connais pas depuis très longtemps. Par contre, je peux vous parler de ma fille. Ça fait pas si longtemps qu'elle était encore toute bébé. Non, quand elle était bébé, elle était magnifique, elle n'avait pas de cheveux. Elle était presque quand même comme son frère Richard, joyeuse, gaie, les yeux pleins de vie. Et elle a toujours été une fille extraordinaire, qu'elle soit petite ou après, quand elle était un petit peu plus grande, à l'école primaire, et ensuite quand elle est allée au collège et à l'université. Nous avons passé des moments extraordinaires ensemble, Quand elle était petite, c'était un petit peu dur la nuit parce qu'elle appelait son papa. Elle disait « Papa, mon bip !» Elle voulait son biberon, n'est-ce pas ? Donc le papa, c'était un petit peu difficile pour lui de se lever pendant que la maman dormait pour lui donner son biberon. Oui. Puis ensuite, elle est allée, après ses études en prépa au tampon. Je laisse Claude Beaufreton faire le joke. Qui était allée au tampon pour faire des études et qu'elle a rencontré, grâce Richard, a rencontré son épouse, grâce à Amélie, puisqu'elles étaient ensemble en prépa. Et donc, la boucle est un peu bouclée. Et Amélie a décidé d'aller parcourir le monde un petit peu. Elle est allée au Guatemala, elle est allée en Argentine, elle est allée en Chine voir les pandas, elle est allée aussi en Afrique du Sud. Je ne vais pas raconter l'histoire parce qu'on l'a déjà raconté deux fois. Mais nous sommes très heureux qu'elle soit allée faire un tour à Cape Town pour voir les baboons. Et elle a rencontré une autre sorte d'animal, mais différent, n'est-ce pas ? Un William Jardinus vulgaris australiensis, excellent. Et donc, après, elle a décidé de faire sa vie avec lui. Nous sommes très heureux, Sylvie et moi, d'accueillir Will. Maintenant, on le connaît depuis longtemps, n'est-ce pas ? Et nous sommes très heureux que notre fille soit son épouse aujourd'hui. Et merci pour la merveilleuse cérémonie que Dave a faite. Et en notre nom, notamment toute notre famille, nous voulions remercier Dave d'avoir si brillamment fait cette cérémonie. N'est-ce pas ? Voilà, donc c'est ma fille, je l'aime. And now I want to just summarize what I just say for our Australian friends. Yes, I would like to thank Kaz to have welcomed Amélie in her family. And I would like to welcome, to thank Rose and James, and Nat and Dave, too. And, sorry. We are very happy, and because Amélie is a wonderful girl, and Will is an extraordinary man, and we wish you a long and happy life. Thank you for everything. We'll be right back.
Thank you.